Bang for the buck smartphones has been the focus as of late, and Asus definitely wants to dive into the same segment with its current Zenfone Max lineup. We've already seen what the Zenfone Max Pro M2 could do, and that it really has some really powerful specs for the price, but some of us might have a slightly lower budget, and this is where the smaller brother comes in, the Zenfone Max M2. The Max M2 sits between entry-level and mid-range as far as specs and pricing is concerned. For just 8,995 pesos, you get a decent 3GB RAM and 32GB of internal storage, along with a very capable Snapdragon 632 processor. I think that's hard to beat if you consider the entry-level market right now in the Philippines. I'm also curious if this actually can game. I'm going to play some PUBG and some Ragnarok online on this, so yeah, this is gonna be a totally exciting review.
By the way, my channel is focusing heavily into bang for the buck smartphones just like this, and even do comparisons, so if you're into that, just subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my great content.
And without further ado, let the unboxing begin! No. Now the box looks really eye-catching. It has the same exact look from its big brother, the Max Pro M2. It looks really stylish and edgy. Inside the box, you get this really nice looking mini box with the We Love Photo tagline. Opening it up, we see the SIM ejector pin with the Asus logo. And inside, we see some documentation, the user guide, and the warranty. And of course, the jelly case. And here we have the phone with all the Max specs in the front. Max performance, Max battery, Max display. We'll cover these guys in a bit. Let me just slip this off. And here's the actual phone itself. First impressions, it looks simple. Definitely not as cool looking as the Pro M2, but certainly looks decent to me. But yeah, let me just put this aside for now. You also get these free accessories right here, an Asus 10-watt charger, micro USB cable, and the earphones. And that is pretty much it. The Zenfone Max M2 has a color blue aluminum unibody design that looks and feels premium. Although the top and bottom portion does look like it's made out of plastic, nevertheless, the overall feel of the phone is really good. The phone just fits right on the hand. Not too big, not too small. The back is matte, so it helps with fingerprints and smudges. The phone also feels sturdy as hell, and also feels surprisingly light, even though it has a huge 4000 mAh battery. So at the back, you get the dual cameras, the LED flash, the fingerprint scanner, and the logo. And at the bottom, we get this really funny looking speaker grill. Thought it was a micro SD card slot, but yeah, I mean, I didn't really put an actual SD card in there, so we have the micro USB slot and the microphone. The headphone jack is actually at the top, power button and volume rocker set to right side, and a SIM tray on the left. And this is where the actual micro SD card slot is, along with the dual nano card slots, so it's definitely the complete package. And now it's time to open the phone. Now what I like about Asus phones is that it usually uses stock Android, which for me is the best and smoothest UI experience on Android. It doesn't have a lot of bloatware, it's very intuitive and doesn't slow down your phone, unlike other skins from other brands. The phone is surprisingly pretty fast, didn't feel so much lag when navigating through social media. Opening apps was also quite fast, I'm guessing near Samsung Galaxy M20 level of speed. That Snapdragon 632 processor really packs a punch. If I'm basing this directly off of the entry-level competition, well, the Max M2 definitely is way ahead any of the other brands at this price range. Although it does only come with one configuration. If 3GB of RAM and 32GB of internal storage is not enough for you, then I highly suggest you go for the Max Pro M2. It has more options to choose from. And now coming to the display, this thing has a 6.3-inch 720p HD+ IPS display. It's a good display. The screen definitely is bright enough for most use cases. The screen is vibrant, although the colors could use a little bit of punch to it. And also, YouTube will only max out at 720p, which is totally fine for most people. The phone also has a very good screen to body ratio of 80% thanks to the iPhone notch design. Now what makes the Zenfone Max M2 really attractive is that it has that huge 4000 mAh battery, which really gives you that extra juice throughout the day. Did my usual PUBG drain test and the results were very healthy. 30 minutes, still at 94%, and after a whole hour, it just went down to 86%. Also tried the charging on this thing. The phone only came with a 10-watt charger, so we're not really expecting fast charging experience on this. At 1 hour, 43%, and a total of 2 hours and 39 minutes at 100%. Actually a very decent speed when you consider the size of the battery. And of course, the full PUBG review. With just a Snapdragon 632 processor to work with, the game can only be played at balanced settings at medium frame rates. Although the game did run very smoothly, it was very playable all throughout. I didn't feel that there was a huge lag in any part of the game. The graphics look pleasing to me, and it looks like the level of optimization for PUBG is very good. I'm really impressed by this, as I really do a lot of PUBG tests, and most entry-level phones really lag, especially during the skydiving part. But this totally nailed it. hands down. The cameras on this thing are pretty decent. I was able to get some pretty nice shots. Colors look really good, not too punchy, and the sharpness is just on point. HDR also works really well here in balancing out the shadows and the highlights. I would have to say that the image quality is surprisingly pretty good for an entry-level phone, and even the video looks really good. Look how smooth that is. Damn. Shut up and take my money. This is the real deal. Asus really did a great job on this. And coming into low light, some grain and image softening can already be noticed in some parts. Also, the highlights are somewhat blown out, but it is very natural to have this kind of quality in low light. This is actually even better than some mid-range phones that I've reviewed before. That's already twice the price this phone. Video at night still looks good as well. You still got that image stabilization going on there. Panning around looks so buttery smooth. And what can I say about the selfies? They look great, beautification is just on point, and that bokeh has a nice touch to it. Although you do get a soft background doing selfies, which means the phone is focusing on my face most of the time, making me look a lot sharper. But the point here is that you look good on your selfies, period. And that's pretty much it for this quick overview on the Asus Zenfone Max M2. I gotta say, this is actually quite a surprise for me. I was not expecting it to be this good. If you're looking into a phone that is below 10,000 pesos, then this is it. I've got almost no complaints here. I mean, it's totally okay to have a micro USB on an entry-level phone, and the charging on this thing is pretty adequate. That is why it really surprised me, as I wasn't expecting these kind of results from this phone. Next up, on TechBeans, the complete battery drain test and charge test between the Samsung Galaxy M20, the Redmi Note 7, the Realme 2 Pro, and the Asus Zenfone Max M2. So be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss it. This is Vince Dominguez from TechBeans, and I'll see you on the next video.